Well, hi there. Previously, we covered the Australian green tree frog, also known as the dumpy frog or White's tree frog. This is not one of those. This is an American green tree frog, which is not even very closely related to the White's tree frog, the Australian green tree frog. For one thing, this is a much smaller frog. Come from a very different part of the world, but they're excellent and I love them. They were recently on our list of the top five small pets for beginners. But I think they're fun for really anyone, not just beginners. It's honestly difficult to imagine a more fun tree frog. For one thing, they're on my short list of the most terrifying hunters in the world. Sometimes I play a game, I don't know if we all play this game, but I play this game where I imagine if I was shrunken down to the size of a feeder, what animals would I want to be in with and what ones would I not want to be in with? The one that I would most want to be in with would be a tarantula, like the Chilean rosehair tarantula that was also on that list, because as long as you didn't bump into it, you'd probably be fine. Green tree frogs, one of the animals I'd least want to be in with, because they are jumping and diving from all the way across the enclosure. You won't even see them coming. Bam! Suddenly, you're swallowed. Amazing. They also just fill me with joy. When I lived in Florida, I used to see these guys all the time, and I'd just go out and take pictures of them and just enjoy them. They've got so much personality, and they're so fun. I also kept them as pets when I was in college, and they're just fun. I just adore them. I've kept other tree frog species. They weren't nearly as much fun as the green tree frogs. And they'll sing to you at night, which is fun as long as you're not trying to go to sleep. To help you figure out if the American green tree frog is the best pet amphibian for you, we will score the green tree frog based on our five categories, which are handleability, care, hardiness, availability, and upfront costs. When it comes to handleability, we give the green tree frog a score of 3 out of 5. You might have noticed I'm wearing a glove. And the reason I'm wearing a glove is because these are amphibians. And amphibian skin, it's great in a lot of ways, but one of the issues with it is that things can pass through it fairly easily. That includes chemicals and the other horror that might be on your hands. And as a result, you've got to be very, very careful that you don't have anything on your hands that you wouldn't want inside of their bodies. And the best way to make sure this isn't a problem is just to wear gloves, but I definitely wouldn't recommend handling them without it, at least unless you're really, really careful about having your hands clean, not just of dirt and bacteria and things, but also of soap or anything you might have used to clean them. They also jump quite a bit. You'll see it in this video. Stick around for the bloopers because there's gonna be some amazing leaps of faith undertaken by this frog. But they jump, and if they get away from you, they're not going to do very well in your house at all. So escape is not something you want to have happen. They also will dry out. That's another issue with that skin. And so keep handling sessions fairly short if you're gonna handle them at all. You really don't have to enjoy them. They're small, so they could easily be crushed or otherwise injured, especially if you hand them to a child or something like that that might not be that careful with them. But they're not gonna do you any harm. I mean, unless it jumps in your mouth and down your throat or something, there's nothing this frog is gonna do to hurt you. It's not gonna bite you. They don't have any claws, so they're not gonna scratch you. They're also really good at holding on. Being a tree frog, you would be amazed how well they can hold on to things. These guys can climb right up glass. They can jump and make contact with a leaf or a branch with just one of their sticky little toe pads and just swing around and stop their whole momentum with it. It's amazing how well they can hold on. When it comes to care, we give the green tree frog a score of 3 out of 5. Care is actually fairly easy for these guys. It's just frequent, which means, you know, you're going to be doing care on a very regular basis for these guys, but none of it's very hard. They're gonna need insect feeders. And so on a fairly regular basis, you're going to have to get a few insects like crickets. Crickets are a good one because they move around a lot. Dubia roaches are excellent, but they tend to bury themselves, so make sure the frog can find them quickly. But you're gonna need access to insect feeders. Make sure those insect feeders are dusted with calcium and also with other vitamins. You're gonna need to keep humidity kind of high and make sure that moisture is available. If it dries out in that enclosure, the frog will dry out too and die. So you've got to make sure that the enclosure is well ventilated, not just sopping wet all the time, but that there's always moisture available. This is gonna mean frequent misting, especially if you don't have a water feature. Like you can see in this enclosure back here, we've got a water feature. That would reduce how much misting you would need to do, but generally speaking, you're gonna need to mist at least once, probably twice a day. And the water quality is extremely important. These guys, they absorb everything right through their skin. That includes chlorine and other chemicals, any impurities in the water. So make sure your water is treated and that you're just really careful with it. The enclosure that they need is inexpensive and easy to find. You know, something the size of like a 12 by 12 by 18 Zoomed or Exoterra tank would be just great for a green tree frog. And the bioactive build that we did in a similar tank to that would be just excellent for these guys. Though I would recommend definitely doing a drainage layer because you're gonna need to keep it pretty wet. With that much misting, a drainage layer is an absolute necessity. Today's video is sponsored by Ridge Wallets. And I've been carrying this Ridge Wallet for a few days now. And one of the things I've found that I really like about it is that they're very, very customizable. One of the first things I discovered was that when I put all the things I was carrying in my big old wallet inside of this wallet, it was too much stuff. And I had to actually make some decisions and trim down. What are the things that actually matter? What do I actually need to be carrying every day? Because I don't need a bunch of receipts and garbage just hauling around with me all the time. And I got it down to a more reasonable package. And I found that I really didn't even need to be carrying money with it. And this comes with a money clip, which is super convenient if I'm carrying cash, but I usually don't. And because Ridge thinks of everything, they actually sent this bodacious screwdriver, which kind of looks like a missile with a star bit on the end of it. And you can use that for all the star bit screws that hold this thing together, and you can take the money clip right off. You know, if this kind of a wallet is what you're looking for, you're probably not gonna find one much nicer than the Ridge Wallet. If you decide that the Ridge Wallet is the perfect pet wallet for you, make sure to check out our link at ridge.com/Clint. You can get yours today. When it comes to hardiness, we give the green tree frog a score of 4 out of 5. Most of them are wild caught, which is why they're ridiculously inexpensive. But because this is a frog native to the United States, at least within the United States, they're not being shipped very far. They're just not undergoing the really terrible conditions that a lot of imports undergo. They generally seem to be in pretty good condition. This is really a very hardy frog if given proper care. That said, excessive heat, lack of water, or chemicals in the water, those are things that can kill your frog very, very quickly. And definitely quarantine these guys if you have other amphibians or other pets of any kind. These guys are coming from the wild, and there's a lot of really unpleasant amphibian diseases out there these days. So a good quarantine period before introducing them to the rest of your collection, very smart. The other thing is these frogs just don't live as long as some of the other frogs we've talked about, some of the larger tree frogs, for example. These guys are gonna live 2 to 5 years, and it's really just gonna depend on how old the frog was when you got it. When it comes to availability, we give the green tree frog a score of 5 out of 5. Of course, that's probably not gonna be the case in every nation on Earth, but in the United States, these guys are in like every pet store that sells any sort of reptiles or amphibians. They're probably gonna have green tree frogs. If you can't find one because you don't have a local pet store, they're gonna be at every expo and they're gonna be all over the internet too. So if you wanna spend $40 to $50 shipping a $5 to $10 frog, it's an option. When it comes to upfront costs, we give the green tree frog a score of 5 out of 5. The frog is basically free. It's hard to imagine how this even works. This is as shocking as the chicken prices at Costco. How do they collect these animals, ship them, house them in a pet store, and sell them for $6? I don't know. Basically a free frog. They also can be housed in some of the most reasonably priced and commonly available enclosures. We'll have links to all these things down in the description, but they're not very expensive. You're gonna need water conditioner. That's a big deal. Before I say anything else, make sure you have water conditioner because water quality is the biggest deal with these guys. Make sure that the aquarium you have has a good lid because if they get out, they won't live long in your house. They're definitely gonna need a water bowl. So even if you're misting regularly, provide them a water bowl. You'll notice what they do most of the time is they'll go and they'll sit in it. and they'll sit in it because they've got a patch of really thin skin right around their thigh area, and they absorb water really well that way. So you'll never see them go down there and like drink. They'll just go and they'll sit in it and they'll absorb water like you do. Since I would recommend a bioactive enclosure just because it's going to minimize your care and it's going to make it beautiful, you're going to want to buy some live plants. You're also going to want hydro balls and screen for your drainage layer. You're going to want some charcoal. You're going to want substrate like eco-earth and probably soil, some sort of plant soil mixture. You can combine those two things. And you're going to want some moss. And like I said, we'll have links to all these things in the description, so this is like a one-stop shop. You're going to want insects, and you're going to want to powder those with calcium and vitamin supplements, so you'll need those. And you'll probably want some lighting. Make sure that lighting doesn't put off too much heat. That light is really for the plants, not the frog. You can get away with less, but why? Why? I mean, this still isn't terribly expensive, and the frog was basically free. These frogs are a lot more fun to watch than they are to hold. Not that they're not great to hold, it's just, it's not the ideal activity to do with them. They're really fun to watch, especially if that enclosure is something beautiful to behold. So make something beautiful. And that is why, overall, the green tree frog gets a score of 4.0 out of 5. I love these frogs so much, and they make just fantastic pets. If what you want is an active, interesting, green little frog, then the green tree frog is probably the best pet amphibian for you. As always, like and subscribe, and we hope to see you real soon.
I like her.
Oh, green tree frogs, why are you so great? Why are you such a great creature? Yeah, you're a great creature. Which are handleability.
Oh.
Care.
Gosh. He landed stuck on the tripod. Stuck the landing. Oh my gosh.
Crazy.
That was amazing.
She's a lady ninja. All right, I'll go get you.
What the heck? How'd you stick the landing like that?
They're sticky.
Yeah.
Man, you're beautiful, though. Look at those eyes. Are you going to jump onto my head? You can say, you are so stinking beautiful. How do you be so pretty? That just continues on.
Whoa! Oh my, he stuck the landing again! That thing is amazing! Oh, yeah.
So, it's the...
That's good.
Ooh, you know, it might be off, but it might be it.
I'm gonna do the closest.
Well, oh. You might just be getting too close.